In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the memorial of the Passion of Saint John the Baptist. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and for mercy. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light and hope to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who willed that Saint John the Baptist should go ahead of your Son, both in his birth and in his death, grant that as he died a martyr for truth and justice, we too may fight hard for the confession of what you teach. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord came to me thus, "Gird your loins, stand up, and tell them all that I command you. Be not crossed on their account, as though I would leave you crossed before them. For it is I this day who have made you a fortified city, a pillar of iron, a wall of brass, against the whole land, against Judah's kings and princes, against his priests and people. They will fight against you, but not prevail over you. For I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will sing your salvation.
I will sing your salvation.
In you, O Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue me and deliver me. Incline your ear to me and save me.
I will sing your salvation.
Be my rock of refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. For you are my rock and my fortress. O my God, rescue me from the hand of the wicked.
I will sing your salvation.
For you are my hope, O Lord, my trust, O God, from my youth. On you I depend from birth, from my mother's womb. You are my strength.
I will sing your salvation.
My mouth shall declare your justice, day by day your salvation. O God, you have taught me from my youth. Until the present, I proclaim your wondrous deeds.
I will sing your salvation. Please stand.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Your word is a lamp for my feet and a light on my path. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Herod was the one who had John the Baptist arrested and bound in prison on account of Herodias, the wife of his brother Philip, whom he had married. John had said to Herod, "It is not lawful for you to have your brother's wife." Herodias harbored a grudge against him and wanted to kill him but was unable to do so. Herod feared John, knowing him to be a righteous and holy man, and kept him in custody. When he heard him speak, he was very much perplexed, yet he liked to listen to him. She had an opportunity one day when Herod, on his birthday, gave a banquet for his courtiers, his military officers, and the leading men of Galilee. Herodias's own daughter came in and performed a dance that delighted Herod and his guests. The king said to the girl, "Ask of me whatever you wish, and I will grant it to you." He even swore many things to her. "I will grant you whatever you ask of me, even to half of my kingdom." She went out and said to her mother, "What shall I ask for?" She replied, "The head of John the Baptist." The girl hurried back to the king's request, to the king's presence, and made her request, "I want you to give me at once on a platter the head of John the Baptist." The king was deeply distressed, but because of his oaths and the guests, he did not wish to break his word to her. So he promptly dispatched an executioner with orders to bring back his head. He went off and beheaded him in the prison. He brought in the head on a platter and gave it to the girl. The girl in turn gave it to her mother. When his disciples heard about it, they came and took his body and laid it in a tomb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
The way how our celebration today is named, the Passion of John the Baptist, the word passion called my attention. Because John faced his passion, pagpapakasakit, because of his passion sa minamahal niyang ginagawang magpahayag o maging propeta. Until the end, we've heard how from our gospel today, John the Baptist never missed the chance to exhibit his passion, which is to preach and to be a prophet even to his people. Narinig po natin kung paanong gustong-gustong makinig ni Herodes kay Juan. But whenever he would hear John, he would feel perplexed, nababagabag siya, naguguluhan o disturbed siya kapag ka naririnig niya ang taong ito. John may have really preached with and through heavy words. He may have been the greatest orator, but he definitely pinched the hearts and the attention of those who heard him. To have honest to goodness preaching. And because of his passion to preach, he faced his passion. Para lang mamatay ang taong may minamahal na gawin, hinantong ito sa kamatayan na dapat niyang harapin. And with that, John was reduced to silence by being beheaded. My dear brothers and sisters, the experience of John the Baptist is very true for us. When we embrace our passion, anumang mga minamahal nating gawin, we are not far from our passion sa mga bagay na magpapakasakit din o magpapasakit ng ating puso. Dahil may minamahal tayong gawin, hindi tayo nalalayo sa anumang magpapakasakit sa atin. You may be passionate in your respective capacities. Your passion for studies, your passion for administration, your passion for coordination, for governance, whatsoever it is. We have a lot of passions, capacities, and capabilities, talents that we can do. But be assured, hindi naman sa pamamagitan ng pagpupugot ng ating ulo. We will face many passions. People disliking us. People who will be indifferent to us. People who will oppose us. People who will be insecure for us or to us. Baka po matanong ninyo kung ganun na lamang, kung ganun pala ang kahahantungan ng mga minamahal kong gawin, then better not to be passionate at all. But John proved it wrong. We may face our passion because of our passion, but God gave us the courage to be faithful to who we are and to be faithful to where God has called us. We may face our passion because of our passions or many passions in life. But let us not be Herods who will definitely kill and put an end to the passion of people. Let us embrace our passion. Be zealous with our passion as we look and also face the passion of our life, where God is most present by carrying us and lifting us up.
Please stand.
Many have witnessed to their faith by their lives. Aware of our mission in the world to be prophets, let us pray to our loving Father to make us faithful to our vocation. For every petition, we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may fulfill with courage her prophetic mission of proclaiming the gospel without fear or compromise. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
That government servants may have consciences based upon the bedrock of personal integrity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our community may stand up and speak out for justice and human dignity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the trials of life may not discourage us, but that our faith may grow through them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the preaching and example of Saint John may inspire those who live in the shadow of death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass and our prayers for each other. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, you bless us with the preaching and example of Saint John. May we offer our lives to your service through our preaching and life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us our bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, we may be accepted by you, Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord our God.
Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
Through these offerings which we bring you, O Lord, grant that we may make straight your paths, as taught by the voice, by that voice crying in the desert, Saint John the Baptist, who powerfully sealed his teaching by the shedding of his blood, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In his precursor, St. John the Baptist, we praise your great glory, for you consecrated him for a singular honor among those born of women. His birth brought great rejoicing. Even in the womb he leapt for joy at the coming of human salvation. He alone of all the prophets pointed out the Lamb of redemption. And to make holy the flowing waters, he baptized the very author of baptism and was privileged to bear him supreme witness by the shedding of his blood. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us offer the prayer Christ himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Buhay na lahat ng lubos.
pag-ibigay tapos. Ikaw, Jesus, ang tinapay ng buhay, binaspasan, hinati, pagsasalong walang hanggan.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, as we celebrate the heavenly birth of Saint John the Baptist, that we may revere, for what it signifies, the saving sacrament we have received, and even more, may rejoice at its clear effects in us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Pusong dahisay dakilan.